Hello everybody and welcome back to Out of Body. My name is Sabrina and in today's video we are doing something quite different. You might notice I have a new little friend over here. I actually purchased a supposedly haunted doll and her name is Colette. Well, my birthday was recently and I decided to get myself a couple of birthday presents. One thing was perfume and then the other thing I thought of, I was like, wait, I have always wanted to try something like this ever since I've seen a couple of people on YouTube and they were successful with it. In other words, like nothing really terrible happened to them. One of those people was Loey Lane. If you guys watch her on YouTube, she has a haunted doll. I don't know if she's done an update recently, but she has one that she was just really, really drawn to and just felt a connection with somehow. And ever since she's had the doll, it's been, you know, a good experience. So randomly one day, and I wasn't even thinking about Loey and her experiences at all, I just felt like drawn to look, just to look and see what was out there, you know, as far as haunted items. And I decided to look on Etsy because there's people who sell them on eBay, but nothing against eBay, but I'm kind of like, I feel like a lot of people get scammed on there. I'm sure people get scammed on Etsy too, but anyway, I just felt like Etsy might be a little bit more reliable. So I just looked on there and I was just looking and I saw a couple that were interesting and I was kind of reading them and I kept seeing her picture pop up. And I was just like, okay, you know, that's another doll, okay, you know, and I was like, oh, that's a clown one, I don't know, because I'm not scared of clowns by any means, but I've never been particularly a fan of them either, so I was like, oh, okay, you know, that one's pretty cute, but it's a clown doll, I don't know, you know, if I would want that. But as I was doing my searching, I kept seeing her listing. So basically, I just felt really drawn to her, so I was like, let me just look at her profile and just see what the story is. I read the story in the description of the listing that the person put down as far as any information about the entity that is attached. It was quite a sad story, and I just felt even more drawn to her at that point. So I, with a lot of thought, a lot of prayer, I will say, and using my intuition, I finally decided to purchase her. So here she is. And things have, she's been here 2 days now. I will say, before anyone gets like worried or scared or like, why would you do this kind of thing? Believe me, I've taken precautions. I've been very careful. I know I'm not super experienced in the realm of haunted objects, but I would say for the most part, I know what I'm doing. I'm not just haphazardly, oh, I'm just going to buy something off the internet and see what happens. No, I made sure to really check my intuition, really see what vibes I was getting from her, because, you know, I am a psychic and I do feel things from photos, and I can tell vibes from photos. I can tell if there's anything negative, and I did not sense anything like that, and I still don't. She's here and I still don't. It's all good things. So I know there'll still be people out there that are skeptics or that are just like probably mad at me for doing this. That's fine. I also just want to take this opportunity to introduce her and to talk a little bit about her backstory, as well as talk about some things that I have already experienced with her. Mostly prior to her arriving, but after I actually clicked the purchase button, things were already starting to happen. It was like we already had some kind of a connection or something was going on. So I'll go ahead and start with talking about her backstory. And as far as where I did purchase her, I will put the seller's info in the description if you want to check out her store. She has other haunted items as well, not just dolls. She has a few dolls and then a few like rings and things like that. And I believe I read on her shop that she gets her things from mostly from relatives that had passed things on to her. So the things are just been passed on over the years. Some of them are actually vessels for paranormal activity. So I'll go ahead and say over here, I've got her little crystal. See, I didn't even realize she was purple and blue until I got her in here. I guess from the photos, like, I couldn't really tell all that well. Or maybe I just wasn't really paying attention to that. But, you know, purple and blue is, like, my favorite color combination. So I thought that was neat, because I already had this crystal, and I kind of felt like she might like it, so I put that there. And, right here I have what they call a cat ball. In paranormal investigations, they use this. So I showed this in my previous video where I was talking about the paranormal equipment that my fiance gave me. And this is one of those things. It's a, they call it cat ball, but it's basically just a, little light up toy. So anyway, I thought I would put this in front of her in case she decides to play with it. I think she's a little bit shy right now. I kind of have felt that, you know, since she's been here, or shy, or maybe just not really interested in coming forward just yet, which is fine. There's no pressure for that. Probably better for us to kind of get acclimated with each other first anyway. Okay, so I'll go ahead and read her backstory. It says, Colette is a little girl who was the daughter of a man and woman who ran a food booth around California and the West Coast. Her and her parents traveled up and down the area, setting up at various fairs and festivals. One early evening, as she relaxed behind the booth with her older brother, she was lured away by a teenage girl who got her attention while playing with a little kitten she got out of her pocket. This girl then took little Colette and quickly handed her over to a middle-aged man. Colette related to me that this happened in Washington State in the late 1960s. As well, the teenager who took her was also a victim, and she was a hitchhiker who got abducted a few years earlier. Colette survived her abuse for a few weeks before she, unfortunately, succumbed to them. She was just 5 years old. She chose to stay on Earth until her parents' passing, then afterwards a bit longer to make peace with the man who abused her. By then, he was in jail for other crimes. She has related to me that he murdered many others and was caught, but not for her, because of the teenager, Lynn. Colette arranges the letters on this lady's fridge, because she has alphabet magnets, so that's how she knew of the teenager's name, Lynn. So her murderer was not caught for her particular murder because of this teenager. Lynn was an abused child and was never reported missing. So I guess because the teenagers that lured her to the man was never reported missing, therefore nobody really knew about Colette being lured away. But there were eyewitnesses that saw her leaving with the girl, but there's never any mention of the man. I've asked her what his name is or was, and she says Ace and Andy a few times that I've asked, but then quickly afterwards she has shown me images of other small children he hurt. So these may be the names of other children. I'm really not sure, but thought it was worth the mention. It does appear that she tends to get a bit uncomfortable when I ask more about this man. When I have spoken with her through Spirit Box and asked more details about what occurred, the most she says is that she was tied with a red rope for many days. Of course, during these times, she sends out deep sorrow and sadness of losing her life so violently. I hold her in my lap during these times and assure her that she has a purpose. Right here and in the now, and that she's appreciated and loved. Colette's sweet little mouth seems to curl up to a wide grin when I soothe her like this. Otherwise, she does get a bit sorrowful and then fussy when she feels overwhelmed. She has rattled at the doors, so I guess she's kind of rattled at doors, open and closing them, as if to say she's had enough. Because of that, I go very gently with her. Otherwise, she is a very sweet and loving little companion, and she is quite satisfied with engaging in lighthearted matters, like making fun predictions and enjoying light games like knock once for yes, twice for no. So I'll have to try some of those. Colette related to me that she chose this vessel mainly because she always loved waiting for and then watching the silly clowns at the different events that her and her family frequented with their business. Oh, her big brother Denny would take her. The two of them would giggle as the clowns would make funny faces and pretend to be hurt. She knew that it was all in good fun, and when she was really being hurt herself, she reverted to this energy on her mind, being safe, happy, and in good spirits with her big brother. Colette has given me the pleasure of visiting me in dreams, lucid dreams, and visions. She's so lovely, taking me on all kinds of sweet adventures where we are walking down different streets at different time periods, meeting all sorts of people as well, playing with animals in the forest. It's always something fun and memorable. She has long, wavy, dark blonde hair, a sweet, plump face, and hazel brown eyes. She has shown herself to me near her vessel as a pinkish-orange orb of light dancing around the nearest window. Colette is a wonderful companion for anyone who is open to having a loving connection with her, as she does need some tender, loving care from her future companion, as she does get a bit restless if she is just sitting alone for days on end. She would rather be placed on a shelf in a bedroom where one who wishes could spend some time with her bonding, as she emits her welcoming and soothing energy. Her sweet vessel is small, only around 7 inches, and is also a music box. I've noticed at times the key on the back of her vessel winds itself up. Sometimes the music follows, sometimes not. Which I actually already tried to wind it up once and nothing happened after that, so that makes sense. I forgot about that. Sometimes it plays, sometimes it doesn't. I have heard her hum a sweet melody, however, a few times after I heard her key wind up. And the key winding can be very loud. This often happens more so on rainy days and nights. Colette's eyes twinkle so brightly during these moments, as she knows she's bringing delightful energy to those who appreciate it. And then there's disclaimers on here, which they have to put all that for entertainment purposes only and all that. So that's pretty much her backstory. So I thought it was interesting that she had so much information about Colette. You know, as time goes on, we'll see what I can experience and find out, you know, about her story as she, you know, feels comfortable opening up. So now I'm going to go into the things that I've experienced since I actually made the purchase. So I did write them down. There's that many. And again, since she's actually been here, there hasn't been much, if anything, that's happened, but I think that's because, you know, she's here and she's content and also just trying to kind of get used to the space and used to me. But again, I only feel good vibes from her, just like the seller put on there that she likes to give out, you know, delightful vibes most of the time. So first thing that happened is, I think the same day that I made the purchase, that night, the doll just kept appearing in my dreams. And, you know, who knows if that was paranormal, if that was just me processing it, but I just thought I would mention it. It felt like we made a connection, nothing negative. I just kind of kept kind of seeing her face. Then either the next night or the night after that, I actually dreamed that I saw a little girl with light brown hair and hazel eyes. And this is, I didn't remember reading that part of the description that I just read about her appearance when she was alive. And so when I dreamed this, like, I just dreamed it, not really remembering that. So that's, I thought that was interesting. I actually dreamed about her when she was alive, and it fits the description of what the seller told me. So I dreamed that I saw a little girl, light brown hair, hazel eyes, in a truck with an older man. She seemed scared. The man pulled over at one point, got out of the truck, and then walked over to her door on the passenger side and opened it. And he got down her level and smiled, very eerie, creepy smile, and was like seemingly trying to cheer her up. But of course she got more scared. She started to kind of lean back and lean away from him. And keep in mind, this is a dream that I had. And then he then kind of tries to grab her, and she tries getting away. And then at that point, you know, I'm kind of in the third person perspective watching what's happening. And I end up, as soon as like he grabs her, I try to get in between them. So I thought that was an interesting thing. And then that's about all I remember in the dream. I get in between them, seemingly trying to like stop him, but also in my mind I was like trying to go through it for her, which sounds weird, but like I was trying to take her place, like, so she wouldn't have to go through it. That's what was in my mind in that moment. So when I went in between them, you know, I almost kind of felt him grab me, like I was feeling what she was feeling. And then I woke up. So the next thing that I've been experiencing, or that I did experience before she arrived, and I kind of still am, is seeing a lot of cloud related things all of a sudden. Now you could say, kind of like when you buy a new car, or new to you kind of car, you start to see that car everywhere. Could be just a case of that, I guess, but I just thought it was weird because I've never noticed really clowns or anything. And it's not just like I started noticing clown things more. It's like I almost felt like things were being sent in to me, you know, as like a sign. So it could be interpreted different ways, but that's personally what I believe. Because I just started seeing like, you know, like I saw like the McDonald's clown one day, and I swear I've never seen that clown in that particular spot somewhere downtown. I was like, I didn't even know he was there, and then I just happened to see him. Or like I'd be watching a video on YouTube and somebody all of a sudden puts like something on the screen that has nothing to do with the rest of the video, but it's got a clown on it. And I'm like, that actually happened last night. I was watching a Graveyard Girl video, and she was unboxing this package of jewelry that she bought, and she all of a sudden takes out these earrings that have clown faces on them, and I was like, oh, that's weird. I believe been experiencing a little bit of seeing like lights at the corner of my eye that I feel like could be related to her. Little streaks of light almost, you know. I don't know if it's really orbs, but just different streaks of light, you know. When I experience that, I usually feel like someone's visiting me, you know, like a relative or an angel or something like that. And I've been experiencing more of that since I did make that purchase. So I felt like it could be related to her. I do believe in like psychic connections, and the energy is endless in the sense of you don't have to be sitting right next to each other to have a connection or to be able to communicate psychically. So like, even though she hadn't arrived yet, physically her vessel was not here yet, I believe I was already having some experiences with her spirit. You know, like her spirit was already around me. Part of why I believe that is because in my out-of-body experiences that I've had when I've astral projected, I know that you could simply just think of being somewhere or think of a person and you're there, you know, and then you can snap back just as fast. So I don't feel like just because her vessel wasn't here yet that she's like so bound to it that she couldn't visit me, you know what I mean? Okay, so the next thing I'm going to talk about that happened, that's still happening, that is very, to me, very significant because it does involve my son. Now, as I say that, nothing negative, again, nothing bad, all good things, but very, very interesting. See, my son is very much interested in learning anything that has to do with numbers, letters, colors, shapes, writing, reading, all the things. Like, he loves learning. Like, that's all day, every day. I feel like people don't always believe me when I say this. It's all day, every day. For those of you who are in my personal life, you know. So he loves books. So, you know, he has like 3 or 4 books that he kind of goes through sometimes. And then he has like the sketch pad thing that he calls his backpack that he, because it does strap onto his back, that he's always writing his numbers in, his letters in, and stuff like that. So he doesn't pick up books as much nowadays, now that he just likes to write. However, I'm pretty sure it was the day that I made the purchase, that night. If not, it was maybe a night, the night after that. My son, it's bedtime, and we have kind of our own bedtime routine. He all of a sudden goes to his bookshelf, which he hasn't done like at all since I set it up. He goes straight, he makes a beeline for that bookshelf, and he keeps saying, "Storybook, storybook." And I'm like, "What book are you looking for?" You know, I thought he was looking for this book about a bear that he got in the mail the other day. And I was like, "Oh, I don't think it's on your bookshelf. I think it's in the living room," you know, and I kept trying to get him to go in the living room. He wouldn't. He just kept looking at the bookshelf like he was looking for something specific. And I was like, "What are you looking for?" And finally he sees the binding of this particular book and he says, "Oh, here it is." And he picks it out and I'm just going to show it to you. It's this book, which has a clown on it. He has never, ever played with this book that I know of. Ever. I mean, it's like he recognized it. That's what's weird about this. It's not just a coincidence like, oh, it's got a clown on it. Because it does also have, well, now that I look at the binding, I don't see how he could have known. Okay, so this is even weirder. When I look at the binding, it actually says, "My School Fun Book," and it doesn't have anything else on there. I thought when he picked it up, when he saw the binding, I thought there was like ABCs on there somewhere. So I was like, okay, he might have recognized it because it does have ABCs in it, which is, you know, something he recognizes right off and always wants to play with. Well, now I'm realizing it didn't even say that. How in the world did he look at that and recognize it as anything? I mean, he can sort of read, but he can't read that good yet. I mean, even if he could, my school fun book, but he wouldn't even know what that is. Like I said, he's never played with this. It's not like this is one he used to play with all the time. And he recognized it, was like, oh, here it is. No, he made a beeline for the bookshelf and then finds the binding only because he's just looking through and he sees, oh, here it is, and just pulls it out. And then I'm like, and my eyes, when I see the cover, you guys, my eyes get wide. I was like, oh, you want that book? He was like, yeah, this book. And then when he opens it up, he sees that there's ABCs and there's numbers, you know, because he loves numbers and all that stuff. And I'm like, okay, this is weird. It gets weirder. Obviously, at that point, I feel like, you know, her spirit is around and she's maybe even, you know, sort of guiding him a little bit, maybe to communicate with me or maybe to kind of play with him. What I thought was heartwarming about it is the fact that this book is very much something that he would love because it's got all of the learning things in it. So it was heartwarming to me because it almost felt like she was trying to connect with him and trying to play with him and give him something that he would enjoy that she enjoys as well. What is interesting about this also is that, you know, he wanted to take it to bed with him that night because, yes, my son takes books to bed. He does not take stuffed toys. He does not take action figures. He takes a book to bed every night and sleeps with it. He takes this one to bed that night. The next morning, you know, he tends to throw things out of his bed sometimes, so it was on the floor. And then he didn't really touch it or play with it for a few days until the night that she arrived in the package. I hadn't opened her up yet. I kind of left her in her package overnight just to put some crystals around her, sage, and kind of do some precautions. That night, he picks up the book and wants to play with it again, wants to look at it again. And he takes it to bed with him again. I was like, okay, that's interesting. Last night, he wants to actually read it with me. So he goes and sits on my bed. He's like, storybook. And he wants to actually go through it with me. And that's when I start to notice. Like I said, it gets weirder. I start to notice in this book, because I was trying to figure out where it came from. It's actually got my brother's name in it. So it belonged to my brother. I know he watches some of my videos. So like, Ray, if you're watching, you probably remember this book. But anyway, he donated a lot of his kids' books to Declan a long time ago. And so, you know, that, again, that's makes sense. But what's weird is in the description of Colette's backstory, it says that when she died, she was 5 years old. On this particular page here, it has a birthday cake and it says, you are five. And five is a very important number. And this is like, I'll play on numbers and says, what is your age added to 10? Yes, 15. Small numbers can be added to make big numbers. Now draw five candles on the birthday cake. So this is actually made for someone who is 5 years old. So that, I thought, was even more interesting. And I didn't, like I said, I didn't discover that until last night when I was going through the book with my son. So that to me was very significant and again very innocent. I mean, I feel like it was actually quite heartwarming. I didn't necessarily see it as creepy or anything, but a little shocking, you know, because I was just like, whoa. Now the last thing I'm going to talk about that I did experience before she got here was a dream that I had, and it was, okay, the significance of this is mostly the timing of it. So I had the dream the morning of the day that she was to arrive. Now, I did not know when she was going to arrive because she was coming from like Canada or somewhere. So, I mean, it took like a good 10 days for her to get here. I don't know. It took a while from the day I purchased anyway. It took about 10 days. So yes, the timing is significant of this particular dream because I did not know she was going to arrive that day because it didn't tell me like when expected delivery was or anything like that. It just said in transit, you know? So I was like, okay. I really didn't know. I knew it could be any day now, but I didn't think it was going to be that day. So keep that in mind when I read you my dream. What's also interesting too about the date, the day that I got her was 3/23/23. So if you're like into numerology, that could be something significant. That reduces to a 13. That's interesting. Just realize that 3/23/23, if you add all those numbers together, it equals 13, which is my lucky number because I was born on the 13th, March 13th. More things I'm discovering even as I'm filming. And what happened in the dream was that I was ghost hunting with another person. I don't know if it was my fiance or somebody else. So I'm following this guy through a doorway. The guy stops in his tracks all of a sudden as we're walking through this doorway in a haunted location. And it's kind of dark in there. And he stops in his tracks as if he sees something. And he shines a flashlight. And he just says, really, like, matter of fact, she's here. And I was like, huh? And then I look around him and I see a figure of a little girl around 5 or 6 years old with a pale face, kind of light colored hair. I couldn't see a lot of details. And then she was wearing a dress, kind of white or grayish, maybe yellow, I'm not sure. So at that point, when I do see her, I start to get sleep paralysis. I start to feel my body kind of getting the vibrations and kind of getting like, you know, just getting that sleep paralysis where I can't move. I can tell when I start to get it. I know what that feels like. And I started to get a little bit scared in that moment because I was like, uh-oh, I'm getting sleep paralysis. And part of me was like, oh, I probably should see if I can have an out-of-body experience. And then the other part of me was just honestly really exhausted and a little bit scared. And so I decided to just try to wake myself up instead, which in hindsight, I'm kind of mad I did that. So yeah, I get the sleep paralysis and then I end up waking myself up. But what's significant is that the guy said, she's here. And then that morning I ended up looking at the tracking information on the doll and it said she was out for delivery. Like she was supposed to arrive that day. And I was like, I didn't really know that she was going to get there that quick because I think the day before I looked at the tracking and it said she was like in Illinois or something. So I figured it'd be a couple more days. Well, apparently overnight she arrived in Memphis and then processed through the facilities. And then that day she was supposed to be delivered and she was. So that was very significant. Now it could have been like a premonition type of dream. I guess, but to me, I feel like it was paranormal. I feel like that was her letting me know, like, hey, I'm here, you know? So, thought that was significant. Anyway, this video ended up way longer than I thought it was going to be. So, like I said, when she arrived, I kept her in the package that night just as a precaution for myself and my home and my son. You know, I saged it, I lit a candle, and I put some crystals around her. I said a blessing and, you know, did all the things. And then about 5 a.m. the next morning, I got up early because I had to go to work that day. So I got up a little earlier so I could do an unboxing video. So I did do an unboxing video of opening up the package. And I did have an EMF K2 meter set up right next to her. I'll let it roll here at the end so you guys can watch that if you're interested. And then, yeah, that is it for now. I will, of course, post updates about Colette in the future videos as time goes on. If you guys have any questions you want me to ask her, let me know, and I might do a spirit box video here soon. So yeah, drop comments down below if there's any questions you want to know about her. Otherwise, I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye! Again, as I open up this package, I only allow energies of light and love and peace to enter my home. I do not allow anything of negativity, anything dark is not allowed in this space. Only those energies of light and love and peace. Alright. Okay, so that's the package. We've got this nice pink packaging here, and it says thank you for supporting my small business. So I did find her on Etsy, the Etsy seller I will disclose down below. If you guys are interested in checking her out, she was very easy to work with and seemed like a very honest person. We shall see how that turns out, but anyway, I definitely got only good vibes from her, and from Claudette herself, so. She had to wrap around her face. Here she is. She is so cute. Can you guys see her? I love the purple and blue. I just realized that those are my favorite colors. It's purple and blue. Ordinarily, I'm not myself a huge fan of clowns, but this one I just thought was so cute and so unique and so different. So, it's actually really cute. I just hope that my son doesn't pick her up thinking she's a toy, because his toy anyway, she's not his toy. But, it's very cute. She may have had a little ball on the end of her hat there at one point in time. Now, she does have a music box in the back here, I was told. I'm hesitating to try that. I don't know. But, oops, there's another one. Anyway, your vessel is now here, Claudette, and I welcome you to my home as long as you are of light and love and peace. If you want to light up the meter, you can at this time. If you want to light up your, I'll turn on your little crystal for you. It can be your little night light. And if you're shy, that's okay too. You don't have to talk. Would it be okay if I played your music box? She's being shy, but that's okay. We don't have to talk right now. I'm gonna go ahead and put you in your little home. Did you like that? Yeah, I can't believe I didn't realize she's purple and blue. That fits perfectly into everything that I like too. So, okay, let's put you in your little home here. Let's see if I can move this. There we go. Switch it to manual focus. There we go.
And I can zoom in too. So there's her little spot. If I can keep it focused. There we go. There's her little spot. So we're gonna leave her alone now. But thank you for letting me film. And we will talk to our friends later about your story. Bye.